Hello friends, now in this video we discuss about the basics of laser. So the objective of this video is to understand and study the basic concept related to laser. So this slide shows that the introductory part of laser. Okay, so laser stands for light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Okay, so the first successful laser was ruby laser. It is a solid state laser built by American physicist T.H. Maiman during the year 1960. Okay, now after that in 1961 a helium neon laser was developed, and that helium neon laser was the type of gas laser, and this helium neon laser developed by the scientist Ali Javan and others in Bell Telephone Laboratory. Okay, now this slide shows properties, or we can say that characteristics of laser. Now first characteristic of laser, that is coherent. So laser light is highly coherent, means this laser light have same phase and same frequency. Okay, now second property of laser we can see here, that is the monochromaticity. Means monochromaticity, mono means single. If there is a single wavelength, then that light is nothing but the monochromaticity. Okay, now third property of laser, that is directionality. Now laser light emit only in one direction. Okay, now next property of laser, that is divergence. Divergence of laser beam is extremely small. Okay, and last one is intensity. Now laser is highly intense compared to the other light. So these are some properties of laser. Okay, now here we can see this slide shows there is a difference between the ordinary light and laser light. Okay, now ordinary light means our light bulb. Okay, now here we can see the difference between the ordinary light and laser light. Okay, now already I have told you laser beam have a single wavelength. Okay, and this ordinary light have more than one wavelength, and hence that is, or this light is not a monochromatic light. Okay, now coherence. Now here we can see the laser light having peaks and troughs. Now here these are the troughs and these are the peaks. Okay, or we can say that crust and trough both are aligned with each other. Okay, and this figure shows here the peaks and trough not aligned with each other. That is, this ordinary light is incoherent light and this laser light is highly coherent. Okay, so this is the difference between the ordinary light and laser light. One more difference we can say, this ordinary light travels in all possible direction, but this laser light is a unidirection, means this laser light travels only in one direction. Okay, so this is the difference between the ordinary light and laser light. Okay, now here the principle of laser. So principle of laser depends on three factors. Now first factor is absorption of radiation or light. Okay, now this is the energy diagram. Okay, so here in this diagram we can see there are two energy levels. Now this is the lower energy state, or lower energy level, or we can say that ground state, and this is another higher energy level, or we can say that excited state level. Okay, now consider the atom is in ground state level, or we can say that lower energy level. Okay, now this ground state atom absorb the energy of the photon, which is E is equal to h mu, and jump to excited state or in higher energy state. So this transition is known as absorption of radiation, or we can say that absorption of light. Understood? One more time I will discuss. Now this is the ground state, this is the excited state, this figure shows before transition, this figure shows after transition. Okay, now before transition, or in case of before transition, what happened? The atom is in ground state. Understood? Now this ground state atom, when absorb the energy of photon, then and only then this ground state atom will go to the higher energy state or excited state. Now here we can say, after absorbing the energy of photon, this ground state atom jump to the excited state atom, and that transition is nothing but the absorption of light. Understood? Okay. Now here we can say that second factor, that is the spontaneous emission. Okay. Now what happen in spontaneous emission? Now we know that there is a natural tendency of the atom to have the lowest energy configuration. Hence, atom in excited state does not stay for longer time. So, it try to come lower state by giving energy of photon, or by giving the excess energy h mu, and that is nothing but the spontaneous emission. Now, if we see this figure, here also we can see this is the before transition and this is the after transition. What happened in before transition? In before transition, atom is in excited state. Understood? Or higher energy state. Okay. Now, there is a natural tendency of the atom to have the lowest energy configuration. That means the atom in excited state does not stay for longer time. It comes to lower energy level by giving excess energy. Okay, now here we can see the atom is in excited state. Okay, now this excited atom electron or excited state electron release their energy of photon, that is h mu, and comes to the lower energy level. That transition is known as a spontaneous emission of radiation. Understood? Okay, now next, third factor, that is stimulated emission. Okay, now what happens in stimulated emission? Now here we can see, in stimulated emission, atom is in excited state. Okay, okay, now here a photon with energy h mu is allowed to incident on the excited atom. Now this excited atom brings, or it brings excited atom to downward transition and releases energy in the form of the photon. This type of the emission is known as stimulated emission of radiation. Understood? Very simple phenomenon is there. See, what happen in stimulated emission? Atom is in excited state. Okay, okay. After that, a photon having energy is h mu is allowed to incident on this excited atom. Okay, so it brings excited atom to the downward transition and releases their energy in the form of photon, and this type of transition is nothing but the stimulated emission. Now what happened here? If we see this figure, then it is observed that multiple photons were observed or emitted in stimulated emission. Understood? So this is the principle of laser. Now this slide shows if we obtain continuous laser beam, the metastable state and population inversion required. Okay, now already I have told you the excited atom, this is the excited state, ground state and metastable state lies between these two state. Okay, so already I have told you the excited atom in excited state does not stay for longer time, that is this excited atom have very short lifetime, which is up to 10^-7 seconds. Okay, hence this excited atom return to lower energy level here. Okay, now metastable state is the state where the atom can remain for longer time than the excited state atom. Okay, this metastable state atom have the lifetime is around 10^-3 seconds. Okay, and that is nothing but the metastable state. Understood? Okay, now population inversion. Okay, now here we can see there are two figures. Now first figure shows there is a normal population. What happen in case of normal population? Here this is the lower energy level, that is ground state level, and this is the excited state level. Understood? Now in normal population, the number of atoms in ground state are more compared to the number of atom present in a excited state. Understood? Now what happen in case of population inversion? Now here also we can see this is the ground state level and this is the excited state level. Okay, now in case of population inversion, the number of atoms becomes greater or becomes larger in excited state compared to the number of atom present in a ground state, and that is nothing but the population inversion. Now according to the name, that is according to population inversion word, the number of atom in excited state becomes greater compared to the number of atom present in a ground state, called as a population inversion. Understood? Now next part we'll discuss about the pumping. Now pumping, it is the process, here we can see pumping is the process of exciting the electron from ground state to metastable state, called as a pumping. Or another definition, we can say that it is the mechanism or process of rising the atoms from ground state to higher energy state, called as a pumping. Okay, this pumping is used for achieving the population inversion which is necessary for laser action. Okay, now the types of pumping, there are three types of pumping. Now here we can see the first type of pumping, that is optical pumping, is there. Now in this process what happen, the light energy, that is photons, which is in the form of flash tube is used. So the ground state atom absorb this energy and excite to higher energy state to achieve the population inversion, and this method is used in solid state laser. Optical pumping, this type of pumping used in a solid state laser. Understood? And which is in the form of the flash tube or discharge tube. Okay, now second type of the pumping is electrical pumping. Now in this method, the electric field causes ionization of the medium and rises it to excited state, and this process is used for the gas laser. Understood? And by mistake it happened, the third type of pumping is chemical pumping. Okay, now what happen in chemical pumping? The exothermic chemical reaction produces enough heat energy to excite the atom to high energy level, and that chemical pumping is used in CO2 laser. Okay, so again one more time we'll discuss about the basics and principle of laser. Now here already I have told you laser acronym light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Now ruby laser was the first laser which is the type of solid state laser developed by the scientist Maimon in the year 1960. Okay, now in 1961 another type of laser, that is helium neon laser, was developed by scientist Ali Javan, and which is the type of gas state laser. Okay, now here we can see there are properties of laser. Now first one is coherent. So laser light is highly coherent. Okay, now second property, monochromaticity. Mono means single. If there is a single wavelength, then it is nothing but the monochromatic. Okay, and this laser light having single wavelength. Okay, now third property, directionality. Now laser light travel only in one direction or unidirection. Understood? Now divergence. Now divergence of this laser beam is extremely small. And last property of the laser, that is intensity. Now this laser light is highly intensive compared to the other light. So these are some properties, or we can say that characteristics of laser. Now here we can see there is a difference between the ordinary light and laser light. Now ordinary light we considered as a light bulb. Now if you see this figure, then it is observed that this ordinary light travels in all possible direction, but this laser light travels only in one direction. Understood? Now this laser light have a single wavelength and this ordinary light have more than one wavelength. Okay, now ordinary light, if you see this figure, then it is observed that the peaks, or we can say that crust and trough, not align with each other. And here we can see the laser light having the peaks and trough are aligned with each other. So this is the difference between the ordinary light and laser light. Understood? Now this slide shows principle of laser, which depends upon three factors or three things. We can say that three things. Now first one is the absorption of light. Now here we can see this figure, then it is observed that this figure shows before transition and after transition. Okay, now what happened before transition? In before transition, atom is in ground state level. Okay, this, or we can say that lower energy level. Now this ground state atom absorb the energy of photon, that is equal to h mu, and jump to the excited state, or we can say that higher energy state. Now here we can see the after transition. After transition, this ground state atom goes to the excited state level, and that transition is nothing but the absorption of light. Now here second thing, spontaneous emission. Now if you see this figure, then it is observed that this is the before transition, this is the after transition. Now what happen in before transition? Atom is in ground state, atom is in excited state level. Okay, understood? Okay, now this excited atom, or the atom have the natural tendency, or there is a natural tendency of the atom to have the lowest energy configuration. That means atom in higher energy state does not stay for longer time. It comes to the downward transition by giving the excess energy of proton. Here we can see atom is in excited state. Okay, now this excited state atom give their energy of photon, that is h mu, and come to the lower energy level. That transition is nothing but the spontaneous emission. Understood? Now, third thing, stimulated emission. Now here we can see, in stimulated emission, a photon with energy h mu is allowed to incident on this excited atom. Okay, it brings excited atom to downward transition and releases the energy in the form of photon. This type of emission called as stimulated emission. One more thing, in stimulated emission, the multiple photons were observed or obtained. Okay. Now here, if we want to obtain continuous laser beam, the metastable state and population inversion required. Okay. Now metastable state. Here we can see this figure. Then it is observed that this is the ground state level, this is the excited state level, and this is the metastable state, which is placed between these two states. Understood? Now, excited atom in excited state has very short lifetime, which is up to 10⁻⁷ seconds. Hence, it returns to lower energy level. Okay, now this is the metastable state. Now, metastable state is the state where the excited atom or atom stay for longer time compared to the excited state atom, and their lifetime is around 10⁻³ seconds, and that is nothing but the metastable state. Okay. Now next one, population inversion. Now here we can see there are two figures. First one shows there is a normal population, and second figure shows there is a population inversion. Now in first figure we can see the number of atom present in a ground state are more compared to the number of atom present in a excited state level. For normal state or normal population, the number of atom present in a ground state are more compared to the number of atom present in a excited state. Okay. Now population inversion means what? The number of atom present in a excited state becomes greater compared to the number of atom present in a ground state, and that is nothing but the population inversion. Now pumping. Now pumping means what? Pumping is the process of exciting electrons from ground state to metastable state, called as a pumping. Okay, or we can say that simply rising the atoms from ground state to higher energy state, called as a pumping. Now this pumping is particularly used for achieving the population inversion, and which is necessary for laser action. Understood? Now there are three types of pumping: optical pumping, electrical pumping, and chemical pumping. Now particularly this optical pumping is used in solid state laser. Now this electrical pumping used in a gas laser. Okay, and third type, that is chemical pumping, that chemical pumping used in a CO2 laser. So this is about the pumping. Thank you.